Very good morning to all the children of class 10D. So after exams, first lecture, we are going to start with a new chapter of the term 2. Fine, because a lot of chapters are there. So we have to continue with the term 2 first. Then we'll start the revision of term 1. Okay, those who have joined now, for them I'm repeating. So Glimpses of India, as the name of the chapter is clear, that after reading the chapter, we'll get to know about the various states of India. So many people, many of us travel, fine. When we go to different states, what do we notice firstly? When we reach a state, yes, just raise your hand and speak. Different culture, Dishan says. What else? Yes, Laksh. Different language, yes, Vivan. Tradition, yes. The person who's raising hand, that person, yes. Variety of food. You know that you got one holiday homework project. Fine, that was the reason, because that is part of your, yes, different dresses. Listen, right. Clear? So when we visit a different place, we get to know, firstly, when we meet the people, there might be a slight difference, the way they speak. Fine, the way they dress up, the food they eat, the weather of that particular place. And behavior of people also. You know that when like Punjabi people are known for their aggression, find the too much ghee in the food, and Punjabi attire is different from other states. So in that way, every state is different when it comes to food, eating habits, culture, dressing sense, behavior, and many other changes. Fine. So in this chapter, Glimpses of India, we will be getting the glimpses of three different states. Fine. So rather than talking about all three together, we'll be picking up one by one. Clear? In one lecture, we'll talk about just one state only. So the very first state is the most famous travel destination of India is Goa. Fine. So a baker from Goa, basically, you're not going to read about the beaches here and the kind of facilities we get when we travel. What we are going to learn is very unknown fact, which we have not read earlier in any of the chapters. And even people who visit Goa, they never bother about to learn about the old culture of Goa. Fine. So Goa was well known state for baking, especially the baking breads and bakery products. Fine. So it was very famous for that. And that's why they have kept the name of this part is a baker from Goa. And the very important thing is all the three parts, baker from Goa, Coorg, and tea from Assam, all three are written by different writers. Okay, whatever I'm speaking, kindly pay attention, because you're listening better. Listening is very important task. 90% preparation is done with listening only. When you listen quietly, be alert, attentive in each and every period. I'm not saying in my period only, in all the subjects, okay? Be attentive. When you listen very carefully, you need not even, you know, give 8 hours study on daily basis. You have to be a smart worker now. So in first part, A Baker from Goa is written by Licio Rodriguez. Fine. And in this, we are going to read about a particular traditional Goan village baker, and who still has important place in the Goa, in that particular state. We people do not know. And you remember when you were a child, you might have that experiences when in the, especially in the people who live in like streets and all, many different eatables would come. Sometimes they have a particular sign to call you. Sometimes they use a drum and the child gets to know, okay, a particular eatable is in the street, and children run to watch and buy that particular thing. Fine. So this is the way. In that Goa also, there was a particular way. They used to, you know, jingle the bell when they would come to sell the breads and all. And they were having sweet breads, different variety of breads and loaves. Fine. And the you can say the largest of the breads and the smallest in the cupcakes, and different forms were there. And children would run when they would hear the jingle sound of the baker, that baker has come. And they were not using the word baker, let me tell you. They were using the word pader, P-A-D-E-R. It means baker in itself. But why it is called pader? Like, pader means baker only. It is a synonym of baker. But we have not experienced that bakers are coming to our houses. We people go to buy bakery products to different bakers, fine? These days, it's in very much trend. Fine, we people go and we buy different kinds of breads and cakes and all. And during those days, only Daksh is not at all attentive in the whole class. Write his name, please. I'm very much serious now. After seeing your performance and overconfidence in the PT2, I'll be interacting with the parents a lot now. If everybody is attentive, you have to be. Clear? So bakers would come after baking. It was a very tedious process. They were not having OTGs and microwaves and big machines. They were using very traditional way. Fine, by using the wood fire and all. And then they would bake, jisko bhatti bhi bolte the. And they would wet very difficult process. Kneading of the dough. Jo aata gunte uske liye, everything from scratch they would start at home, and after making they would pack it and they would put in the basket, and then they would carry that stick with jingle, and they would shake that stick outside the houses of people. In the morning people would come out, pay them, and they would buy breads from them. So that was a traditional Goan way of buying the breads and all. Clear? So this is what we're going to read in this chapter, very interesting way. So let's continue. A baker from Goa. This is a pan portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in her society. So pan portrait means character sketch. When I say give me pan portrait of a baker, it does not mean a particular baker, means all the bakers in one whole integrated way. If I say, give me the pen portrait of a farmer, what you will say? A farmer is a very simple man who wears very simple clothes, kurta, pajama, dhoti and all. And the one who wakes up early in the morning. When you describe a person or a profession, this is the way to describe. You will tell firstly the attire, the character traits, what that person does, fine? How he plows the fields and all. So similarly, when we will describe the pen portrait of baker from Goa, we are going to tell everything. The way he used to dress up, fine? He would wear a long single piece dress till knees. That we are going to read. A particular word is there. So in this chapter, different vocabulary is used. The way first word we have learned is pader, fine? This is a pen portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in his society. Our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days. Now, very important thing is they are going to project Goa in the Portuguese days. Fine? So many. Mera period nahi hai tab 11:25 kaun sa period hoega dekhna kya aise thodi na main agar period hua to then I won't be able to. Gate number 3 ho I hai kaun sa okay that is 11:20 theek hai fine so Portuguese days they have mentioned. What do you mean by nostalgically? They have written thinking fondly of the past. When you miss your past, that is nostalgia. What do you mean by nostalgia? Beta, we are learning new vocabulary also. Okay, second word we have learnt is nostalgia. Don't think that only toppers will learn. Everybody can learn new words. The thing is, if you concentrate, nostalgia is missing your past memories. Suppose you miss when I was a kid, I would play a lot. Now I'm burdened with the studies. I miss my childhood days. Means that is nostalgia only. Clear? So our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days, the Portuguese and their famous loaves of bread. So people who live in Goa, the old people especially, they nostalgically miss those past memories, that how they would relish the bakers. Now this tradition is going out of fashion, fine, in the present Goa. But it is not that people do know about the bakers. They still exist also. But the fashion is going, fine. So the old people of Goa, they miss those good Portuguese days. Those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. Eaters of loaves means the people who would buy bread on daily basis, they are now very less in number in present Goa. But makers and their families, fine, posterity is still there. What is posterity? Posterity is coming generation. This word is not used in the chapter. I'm just discussing with you all. Clear? We still have amongst us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. So when the custom was there, everybody used to divide the responsibility, fine, in the family only. One would do the mixing. You know that many of the girls might have tried their hands on making cakes during the lockdown. Many of us were doing that, fine, ingredients and all. So in that way, in the family itself, many people were mixing, molding, and those who would bake, and there is an art in it also, that how many degrees Celsius are required and for how many minutes. Otherwise, it may burn also. Those age-old, time-tested furnaces still exist. So they would bake cakes in the, or loaves of breads in the furnaces. Jisko aap bhatti bol dete ho, fine? It still exists over there. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. Underline this line. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. They are saying that it is not totally vanished. Jiska meaning ye hai. Deeper meaning of this line is that fire of the these furnaces is still not out. It's still burning. Means still some people are existing who bake loaves of breads. The thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo. What is the thud? Thud sound is like this. When I do this, this is a thud sound. So they are saying the thud and jingle of traditional baker's bamboo. So now you get to know that the traditional baker, he would bring a bamboo stick. Fine? Bamboo tree ki bani ek stick hoti thi. He would bring that bamboo stick and a bell tied up on that stick, and he would thud outside the houses of people. Heralding his arrival. Heralding means announcing. It is written over there, beta. Heralding his arrival in the morning can still be heard in some places. So at some places in Goa, still bakers come in the same manner. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. So maybe the father or the grandfather who would bring those bamboo sticks and bells and breads, maybe he's not there. Maybe the grandson or maybe the son has carried on the profession. So still at some places, this tradition is going on. These bakers are even today known as Pedar in Goa. So underline this line, that still these bakers are existing. They are not out of population. They still exist and they are known as Pedars in Goa. During our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion and guide. Now, why a baker is called a friend? Why a baker is called a companion? Sathi bola gaya usko, guide bola gaya. How? Why? He used to come at least twice a day. First reason is, baker would come in the morning and in the evening also. Fine, two visits per day. Once when he set out in the morning on his selling ground, and then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket, the jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Fine. So it was a kind of excited you can say gesture of the children, that whenever they would hear the jingle sound of that bamboo stick, they would run outside their houses ki okay baker aa gaya, let's see. The jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Why would they greet him, wish him? Was it for the love of the laugh? Love of the laugh mean laugh. What is a laugh? A bread leke aate ho, that is a laugh of bread only. But exactly meaning of laugh is, it is a large chunk of bread which we need to cut. You have seen the fruit cake. That is a laugh of bread only. Jo aajkal aap khate ho and you will be distributing during Diwali days also. Fine. The big large piece of bread is called a loaf of bread. So, not at all. Was it love of the loaf? Not at all. The loaves were bought by some Paskin or Bastin. Underline this. The maid servant of the house. They are saying now, writer is telling us ki why we would run to meet and wish the baker outside our houses, not because of the bread, because we had servants at home. Somebody's name was Paskin or Bastin. Such kinds of names were in fashion. So he's saying we had servants who would bring those breads for us. So why would the children run? What we longed for were those bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Underline this. There is a particular item in the basket known as bread bangles. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. So a particular item was there, which was known as bread bangles, and children would love that sweet bread. So that's why they would run to find it. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with jhang jhang sound of his, you should know, you can get an MCQ. What sound was produced by jhang jhang, jhoom jhoom, jing jing? You will be, aapka dimag us time mil jayega. So you should know. Now you have gone through the MCQs. Be prepare yourself for the worst. Expect the best, but prepare yourself for the worst. Ki kuch bhi aa sakta hai. Any unimportant thing can be there also. Boards aside, you never know. This time board is going to send you the paper. Fine. So, he says, whenever they would hear the jang jang sound of his specially made bamboo staff, one hand supported the basket on his head. Dekho, kitni mehnat hai. With one hand, he would hold the basket on his head only, and the other bang the bamboo on the ground. We people are like very shirkers. We never, you know, prefer the hard work, physical work. So he would carry, baker would carry the big basket on his head and bamboo stick in the other hand. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. So that was the way of selling. He would come, he would make that sound of jhang jhang and people would come out. Then he would wish them good morning and then he would keep the basket on that stick. We kids would be pushed aside with a mild rebuke and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. And obviously parents, they start scolding their kids. Kids jo hai wo zyada hi excited ho jate hain, and so they were scolded by parents and servants would collect those loaves of bread. But even then we would not give up. Writer is saying as a child. Fine. He's saying that we would never give up. And we would climb a bench on the parapet and peep into the basket somehow. So there was a bench in the veranda maybe. And they would jump over there and they would try to have a look inside the basket. Because they cannot see into the basket. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths. When the moment they would hear the sound of the jingle, they would run out. Right? Then we did not even care, fine. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? Now see, another feature. Means they were not having toothpastes to brush their teeth. They would use mango leaf. You know, people in the olden, older times, they would use natural things only. So they would use mango leaf for the toothbrush. And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. So कहते हैं ना कि शेर तो नहाए धोए होते हैं. It's a saying in Hindi. So he's, the children are giving explanation of not brushing their teeth actually. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. So kids are saying we would never brush. Parents would scold us. The moment we would hear the sound of jang jang, we would run out, get that bread and enjoy that with our morning tea. So we never bother to brush our teeth. Is it clear to all? Fine, online children, beta, send me your feedback. Is it clear? I'll continue and question answers we'll do tomorrow. Okay. So we are on page 87 now. I share the screen here now. We are having book. There is no need otherwise. There is no need. Let it be. You might be having books. Page 87. Better try to finish it as soon as possible because a lot of things to do. Yes, marriage gifts are meaningless. Now they're after telling about the kids' excitement of getting the loaves of bread, they're going to tell that why these baking products were important. Marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread, underlined beta, known as bowl. The bowl, B-O-L. First category was bangles, fine, of bread. Second category is the bowl, B-O-L. Bowl is the sweet bread. Marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as the bowl. Just as a party or a feast loses its charm without bread. Not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for a village. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. Cakes and bolinas are a must for Christmas as well as other festivals. Thus, the presence of the baker's furnace in the village is absolutely essential. Now, in this paragraph, we have learned about importance of baking during the festive season and during the functions and marriages and parties at home also. So any function, any marriage was, when you go to a party, if you just relish it and they do not offer you food, or if they offer you food, they do not offer you a dessert, a sweet dish. You say now that there was no sweet dish. We people start finding faults at marriage functions. Yeah, tasty. Yeah, this is not tasty. The person has prepared with a lot of efforts, fine. Similarly, they are telling the importance of this bowl bread, B-O-L, sweet bread, which was very important part of all the festivities. Clear? The baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar, now the better dressing sense. Next paragraph is going to tell about the dressing sense of baker. The answer sunne. The baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar means strange. Peculiar is strange. Dress known as the kabai. Kabai unki dress ko bolte the. It was a single piece long frock reaching down to the knees. Fine, whether obviously bakers were mostly men and they would wear kabai. Kabai is a long frock till knees. And in our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trousers, which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pants. Means if they are not wearing kabai, they would wear trousers and shirts, but the length of the trousers was not full length. Capri style, you can say. Fine. So it was more than half pants, less than, you can say, ankle length or above. Even today, anyone who wears a half pant which reaches just below the knees invites the comment that he is dressed like a peder. Isiliye, if in Goa somebody is wearing a pant which is neither a half pant nor a full pant, people start saying that you are looking like a peder, because that was a typical style of a peder to dress up. Is it clear? Kabai is clear to all. It's a long piece of frock, single piece of frock till knees. And trousers, they were never used to wear long pants or half pants. They would wear more length more than the half pants, right? The baker usually collected his bills at the end of the month. Now, next important thing is they would never ask for money on daily basis. It was like every house would buy bread on daily basis. At the end of the month, they would collect money from each house. Monthly accounts used to be recorded on some wall in pencil. How would they record? They were having pencil and they were using a wall of their own house to maintain the record. It's not record. Fine. There are two pronunciation of this word. You might not be knowing. Ye jo word hai, isko do tarah se pronounce karte hain. If it is used as a noun, to isko record bolte hain. If I'm using it as a verb, then I will say record. Okay. I say I'm recording the gestures of all of you. Recording. Then I'm using it as a verb. So bakers were having the record of everything. I'm using it as a noun. Is it clear? Clear hai sabko? Koi doubt to nahi? So they were using the wall of their own house where they would write with a pencil the monthly account of each and every house. They were not having paper and pen and all. Fine. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. Even these days, it is quite profitable. The baker and his family never starved. Starved means bhookhe rehna, without food. Without food means starvation. So they are saying in the old times, baking was a very profitable profession. Families of bakers would earn good amount. Fine, they would never starve. He, his family, and his servants always looked happy and prosperous. They were also having servants at home, and they would always look happy and prosperous. Their plump physique was an open testimony to this. Plump is fat, obviously. Fine. So the more bakery products we eat, the more plump we become. So the plump physique was a testimony of that they are from the baker's family. No baker was quite thin, or you can say sleek. Their plump physique was an open testimony to this. Even today, any person with a jackfruit-like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. So there are different kinds of physique. Hourglass physique, jackfruit physique, fine. So whosoever was having, what is a jackfruit kind of? Like, when they become heavier from the bottom and they are thin from upside. So that is called jackfruit-like physique. Okay? Sit straight. You are having your own book. Even then you are looking back. Clear? So even today, any person with a jackfruit-like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. Whenever now in Goa, baking professionals still exist in villages of Goa. In cities, it is less known, but in villages, that tradition was quite common. But nowadays also, it is not over. It is less in number as compared to old times. Clear? So this is all about this. I will be asking questions to those who are very attentive. Yes, what are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? First question, just raise your hands. Raise your hand and then I'll give you the chance. Otherwise, I will name the child. What are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? In the beginning of the chapter we read. Yes. Bell ho gayi rahe do, let it be. Okay, children, online children, is it clear to all of you? So we'll continue with the question answers tomorrow. Have a nice day.